It is April in Michigan, and this is not how we want things to look. But I have about a 2-hour window to get some walking and some running around done before it starts snowing like crazy. And one of the things that helps me get my life done, especially on these unpredictable days, is a little app called GoogleKeep.com. It's a little app called Google Keep, and you can find it at keep.google.com. I'm back in the home office after my 2 hours of running around, getting some shopping done, going to the gym. One great thing about being a writer and one great thing about working out of your home office is that you have a lot of flexibility with your schedule. That's great. I tend to look at Weather Underground in the morning and kind of come to this idea of, hey, what's the day going to look like? And if I see a 2-hour window where I can get stuff done before the snow comes or for something's going to hit that's going to be crazy, I'll take that 2-hour window because I'm flexible enough where I can work on something else later on in the day. So that'll work out for me. And it's also kind of got a downside too. The man in my life, the guy that I live with, Greg, and we've been together for about 20 years, he's got a flexible schedule too. So I wanted to show you that app that we use as a couple to keep our lives in order since we're both so flexible. And what I'm gonna do right now is hop behind my computer and show you what I do. Before I show you Google Keep, I wanna show you what prompted us to start using the app in the first place. This is a text exchange between Greg and I, and it's a fairly typical exchange that you might see with a lot of couples who have variable schedules or flexible schedules. I might find myself at the store, in this case I was at Aldi, and I would text, other than eggs, what do we need? And he would text back a shopping list of what he wants, and I may or may not get it by the time he texts me back because I don't know whether he's in a meeting. And vice versa, he's texted me while I've been in a meeting and I've had my alerts off too. So what prompted us to use the app is the missed connections and our variable schedules. And so here we are in Google Keep, and I want to show you how I use it. You can see that I use it for a lot of things other than groceries, just reminders and so forth. But here I created a specific label for groceries. I did it just by adding groceries and then clicking done. You can add whatever label you want. But to sort it out, I'll click on groceries, and all the things that I created with the label of groceries will pop up. And I created one for a lot of the different stores that I tend to frequent. I'm going to create a new list so you can see how I did that. I am going to create a new list, and I'll create a new store, one that I tend to frequent from time to time, called Fresh Time. And another thing that I'll do is I'll look at the sales for the week, and Fresh Time might have sausages on sale this week, so I'll include that in my list. And the next thing I will do is create a reminder, and I'll do it per place. And I'll type in Fresh Time and then select the one that's in Grand Rapids, Michigan, since that's the one that I would tend to frequent. The next thing that I would do is select a collaborator, and I'll type in the name of my partner, Greg. So he ends up being a collaborator with me on that list. So what happens now is when either of us drive past Fresh Time, we will get a reminder, and we know that we have things to buy there, and that's what's on our list. And what we also know to do, if you take a look at each of the lists, like Aldi, is after we've picked something up, we cross it off the list. That way, we don't interrupt each other throughout the day with annoying little texts, and we know what to buy for groceries. That's how we use Google Keep to keep each other communicated with without interrupting each other throughout the day. If you like what you saw here, hit the subscribe button and we'll talk to you later. Use some Google Keep and see if it keeps you communicating.